Yellow Home
with Ella Schofield
and Big House.
And here we are, and it's Wednesday night, day before the weekend. We're live through till 8 o'clock. I'd be lying if I didn't say this is a very, very special show. It's our favourite time when we have live guests, and it's Yala live tonight, right through till 6. We have a very special guest.
Yeah, no, 100%. Salaam alaikum, everybody. Peace and love. We do have a special guest. We have Emirati magician, mentalist, illusionist. He's, of course, from the UAE, and he is... I think he's known for his street magic. I had the pleasure to just see him right now, which is interesting because, you know, I knew of him.
Yes.
And then I just realized that he was hosting this TV show that I was a fan of, which is really
That's
interesting.
Amazing.
He didn't do magic on the show,
right,
but it was just really interesting. So put two together, very humble guy and very talented. Moein Al Bastaki is with us, ladies and gentlemen, and he's going to be doing tricks live and he's going to be answering questions. We're going to talk magic. We're going to talk illusion.
We're going to talk hypnotism because we were also watching you. We know that you hypnotize as well. So we have no idea what to... It's exciting.
Yeah, yeah. Very, very exciting. Okay, yeah. What else is coming up in the show?
So much is going on. Obviously, we need to do a roundup later on of what's going on around the world, of which there is lots. But one of the big things is that the UAE announced today that residents outside of the UAE who haven't been able to get back yet, because obviously countries' borders are all kind of open, closed, everyone's in chaos, they've extended it for 6 months till March 31st so everyone can get back in.
Amazing.
Well done, the UAE.
Cool. I'm going to give you some updates on the NBA as well. I think basketball is life.
Course.
And there's a couple of NBA players here for somehow. They're ex-NBA players that are in the UAE.
I think I saw one today.
Which is just... Really? Wow, that's...
He was in full gear.
That's because he's tall? That's what I'm like...
No, yeah. Okay. I mean, yeah. Okay. Tall, massive, huge, like, look up kind of guy.
Yeah, yeah.
But also he was in... The clue was in what he was wearing.
Okay, okay.
So I nearly accosted him and went, you know... Hey, but I thought, well, I'll just look silly. So
you should have, yeah, that was interesting. We're talking about parent fatigue as well. Homeschooling leaves European parents with fatigue and anxiety.
Well, they've gone back into lockdown, most of the European countries, and they've already had their kids off for 10 months this year. So now it's gone back down into lockdown. Literally, parents are rinsed and they're going, I don't know what I'm going to do. Because, of course, they've got to go to work as well. So it's very, very difficult.
Yeah. 100%. It's going to be an exciting show, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to go for a track right now by Saudi rapper. His name is Mulham. Incredible guy. And up next, we have Moein Al Bastaki, who's going to really, like, blow our mind. I'm pretty sure it's going to be interesting.
We're ready.
Yellow Home.
Ella Schofield.
Big House.
And it's Yala Home through till 8 o'clock. We're totally live. It's very, very exciting because it's Yala Live tonight. We have the most amazing guests, a magician, hypnotist, all sorts of incredible things. And I've been practicing the name.
You can say it, Ella Schofield. We're proud of you.
Mo Bastaki.
Al Bastaki. Yeah, makes
thank you very much.
You're so welcome. This is very,
very
exciting.
Thank you very much. I'm pleased and honored to be present here with you guys.
Habibi.
Big Has, of course, been following him and his talent and yourself also,
Thank
Anna.
You so much.
God bless you.
Thank you for inviting me over, and hopefully we'll be light guests for you guys and perform some nice magic. Hopefully everybody's going to enjoy it.
Man, God bless you. I just want to see if people are watching us on YouTube.
YouTube,
if you
definitely.
Can get move to the right a little bit, just to make sure, you know,
right,
we're just... If you're listening to us right now, you can watch us on YouTube. Just want to make sure we're getting the camera right. But I'm sure, you know, our main man, Super Gabby, will fix that. Moein, يعطيك ألف عافية. God bless you. Thank you so
Thank
much
you
for coming
much.
Through
Thank
right here on Chargers First and only English
My
radio
honor.
Station.
My honor.
I think the first question we both want to know and everyone wants to know, and please feel free if you want to ask Moein Al Bastaki any question. He's a magician, he's an illusionist, he's a mentalist, really crazy guy. 4215, it's a lot, and to keep the questions coming. How did you fall in love and in passion with
this?
What you're doing this right now?
Yeah. Well, the whole story starts when I was 6 years old.
Mm.
And to everybody's shock, like 6 years old, you wouldn't be reading, able to read even, yes? My grandfather knew magic from his travels. So he was a traveler. And to learn some magic, my dad and my uncle both were not interested to learn any.
Okay.
So I was the victim in this story.
God bless.
So I was playing with the puzzles that my dad had gotten me that night. And while playing with these puzzles, putting them together, I think it was a Mona Lisa picture.
Okay.
My grandfather goes, Moein, come, I want to see you. And I'm busy with the puzzle. I don't want to go. He calls me again, so I go. He takes a coin, a 1 dirham coin.
Yeah.
And he bites on the coin. He brings the coin out, and it's bitten in half.
Oh, wow.
So I go, this guy has a very strong teeth. I mean, how did he do that? So then he's like, wait, he shook the coin and it went back to a full 1 dirham.
Amazing.
To my shock and surprise, I ran. I went to everybody who didn't want a dirham that was a little bit bent or just didn't want it. And I went to my grandpa and I was like, this is 20 dirhams, make them 200. I want to buy a bicycle. Wow. So he was, nice he going. Revealed the first secret goes, yeah. This is not an actual coin. This is a magic coin
right.
that I performed for you.
Yeah.
So that was my first view of magic, of what could be magic. And then the journey was him teaching me all the tricks that he knew.
Amazing.
My dad at that time had a store of renting and selling VHS and Betamax tapes.
Marshall, now, if you remember what a VHS, I love you. I'm just saying.
I remember. Videos. Great.
Yes. Yeah. So he used to get the master tape. At that time, there was no copyright in UAE.
Right.
A master tape from US, make 50 copies at home. We had this big room with lots of VHS players.
Wow.
Fantastic.
And he used to sell them in his store with packaging them.
That's right. Mad.
So he used to get the David Copperfield master tape at that time. And he used to bring and give it to me like, take this. You're going to love, because you like magic, you're going to love this. So I used to watch David Copperfield.
How old were you at that point?
Mm. Oh, 6, 7,
okay,
8.
Still.
He had this shop way before I was born.
Mashallah,
so
that's crazy.
I saw David Copperfield vanishing the Statue of Liberty.
Yep.
And then I did my own vanish of Burj Khalifa.
Just
a couple of years ago.
Trying to impress you with some tunes
with
right here.
With some magic tunes.
X-Files right here.
I was like, why is he playing a song while I'm talking?
X-Files right here. Magician. But yeah, wow, that's
so interesting. So you vanished the Burj Khalifa?
The Burj Khalifa video. We've got
incredible.
Like more than a million view on... on YouTube, so on that specific video.
Incredible.
So that was one of the things that just to give back to what inspired me in the world of magic, David.
Yeah.
Magic, yes.
Okay. Mashallah, you've been doing this professionally from since when? Like professionally?
2008.
And eight.
2007-8, I started, that was the beginning of YouTube, I believe, a couple of years into YouTube live. And I started posting some video, but I was posting under a fake name. Because I was worried the people in the society are not going to accept the art of magic or what I'm doing is magic or illusion.
Yeah.
Because they tend to believe whatever I'm doing is just real magic.
Yeah.
So I hid my identity and then... In my first TV appearance, 2010, in a morning show, after talking to a friend of mine, should I go with my hidden identity or should I go with my real name?
Yeah.
He's like, just go with your real name.
And you did.
And I did. And I was impressed how much people were supportive than being against what I'm doing in the art of magic.
So you didn't face a backlash?
I did, but then if you weigh both the categories of supporters and the haters, supporters were very much more.
I just think it's interesting, obviously, in this region, look, it's something like on the ropes. A lot of people would see it, you're like, oh no, how can he do this, how can, like, you know, she do this or whatever. So when you decided to take that step and be yourself, did you have any doubts? I'm talking about between you and yourself.
I was so much worried that my family wouldn't accept it, and in the beginning I found a pushback from my father, from my sister, from family. Yes.
Mm.
Like, what are you doing? I mean, this is not okay.
Become a doctor, become an engineer. The
here
same
we
topic.
Go.
Right,
yeah,
right.
Same thing goes on.
So,
same discussion.
So I got, my dad was totally not on my side until I became famous. Then he was like, I'm a big fan of yours. Now I'm okay. You're making some money. That's good.
And now he's proud of you.
No, he was then. Yes.
Actually, thank you for saying that. I face this a lot with many producers, rappers, hip hop artists specifically, and they tell me the same thing. And I know where the parents are coming from, to be honest. They're just worried about you.
Sure.
They want you to become successful, and they know whatever you're doing, whether an artist, rapper, magician, ma hajib fulus, you're not going to make money out of this.
Yes.
And I want you to be independent. I want you to be okay.
Yeah.
So now when you prove to them that you can make money...
Happy days.
That was. And he was a big fan. I mean, he's no more with us.
God rest his soul.
He went to a better place last year. So he used to be like, he used to spread all my videos, any TV appearance, everything.
God rest his soul in peace and power, man.
So, Allah irhamu. So the thing is that I faced difficulties in the beginning.
Yep.
But then I proved that this could be an art, an unexplored art in the Arab world that people could learn, could enjoy, could just, you know, perform. I mean, I always encourage parents to teach their kids magic because kids face difficulties in communicating and being social with people. They don't know how.
Yeah.
They go to school and this is a new school and they want to be friend with that kid, but they don't know how to be friend with
them. It's a very cool way to break barriers.
So when they do magic...
You're going to teach us a couple of tricks? Me and
Done deal, of course, yes.
And speaking about that, I just want to shout you out because, you know, Moein has these products that you can buy. And it teaches you a little bit of magic, which is really cool. They're available on in stores and online.
That's
which is
fantastic.
It's a nice way to give back, to be honest. And they're like very good price, to be honest. You can give it as a gift to somebody and they learn how to make other people happy.
Yes.
So in my culture, in the West, definitely, I've been here 10 years, but when I grew up, the magic sets are huge for kids.
Sure.
I mean, you can get them everywhere and kids love it. I mean, they really do. So my son went through his phase of trying to do magic and he had this set and there were little metal triangles and you had to pull them apart and various coins and things like that. But I think you're onto something there because kids are fascinated.
Definitely.
Kids are a great audience.
Yeah.
So do you like performing for kids or do you like doing it with adults? Mm. What do you prefer?
The thing is, it is not about if you like this or that.
Yeah.
It is the magic differs. The magic that you perform for kids are not the same magic that you do for adults.
Right.
So your talent, you should have, it depends on where your talent stand. Is it you performing for kids or are you performing for adults?
Mm.
But I do all, I do both. I love kids. And I'm aiming to have my son become a magician, so we'll see when he's grown up if he's going to do magic or not.
Yeah.
In my magic products, actually, the small add-on there is that I teach in Arabic also.
Amazing.
So I have the whole DVD in Arabic.
Yeah. I love the fact they said DVD.
So, we are VHS, DVD, Betamax and all that.
80s kids, man.
Yeah.
Listen, before we go take a break and then, you know, get back to action where we're going to hypnotize Anna Schofield today. But yeah, no, I'm just...
I'm ready.
I wanted to ask you, when the masses of the people, watch a magician or illusionist online, we're so fascinated with how they impress other celebrities.
Sure.
It's a big thing on video.
Yeah, you're right.
Oh, this guy, oh, look at him. He's like with this celebrity. This video does well. Or he's with the NBA player.
Definitely.
Yeah.
I want to ask you, who is that personality that you, as Moein, really enjoyed showing your magic illusion to?
I've a few. I've done for big names, big celebrities. The videos are there with me on YouTube. I've done with the late Maradona. That was
I
performed for him and
incredible. Rest
Maradona
in peace,
being Maradona,
yeah.
He hugged me after the trick and to me it was like, oh my god, look, he's not punching me, he's hugging me. So you know Maradona is gonna
be Mike Tyson would be an issue.
I actually performed for Mike Tyson.
No way.
So I did.
Amazing.
I did perform for John Travolta.
No.
Yeah, my video with him is there on YouTube. I read his mind. He just gave me an amazing reaction. I did for John Cena. Fabio Cannavaro.
What?
I did
Fabio Cannavaro. Italian.
I'm Arab celebrities. Everybody you would think of, I've done performance for.
So fantastic.
Okay, let's ask you a different way. Who's somebody that you know you didn't expect a reaction to, whether it's good or bad? Like someone that shocked you with a reaction.
The thing is, I think all these performers or all these, let's say them being actors or a sport personality, they always perform.
Sorry.
Yeah.
They want to stop performing and they want to be performed at.
Yes.
So that's what they love.
Mm.
You expect, okay, John Cena is so huge.
Yeah.
I don't know how is he going to react. But then my video with him was one of the most viewed videos on YouTube of
is
my videos.
Is it on
videos.
Your channel? People
it
can
is,
see it?
It is
okay.
There. In Saudi Arabia, it got viral, the John Cena video.
Wow.
And he gave me an amazing reaction. So the thing is, they've all been kind. I'm not remembering anybody that was not really kind to me while performing for them.
Tell me, whoever's not kind to you, tell me. I'll show them.
You're going to sort them out. Pass will sort them out. Personal protection right here.
Yeah, of course. But no, this is really fantastic and amazing. We're going to take a very short break with an amazing song. But then after that, are you ready to show us what's
awesome.
Happening?
Because definitely.
There's a lot of tension. Not tension. I mean, energy in the building right here.
Yeah.
And I feel like he just did a trick right here off air before we begin with Mike and Aisha. And Anna, he guessed Aisha's password.
Did you really?
And I'm like, she didn't know.
She won't like that. I know Aisha.
I was like,
she'll
she's changing.
Like,
the first thing she's changing.
She has to change it.
Yellow Home with Ella Schofield and Big House.
At 5:32, driving you home, we're live across all seven Emirates, and we have the pleasure to be joined in the studio by the legendary magician Moein Al Bastaki tonight.
Moein Al Bastaki, ahlan wa sahlan. Again, thank you so much, man, for coming through. We got to know a little bit about your early life, your passion, you know, and your love for VHS and DVDs. No, that's amazing. And now let's get into action, man. So you can watch us on YouTube, ladies and gentlemen, Pulse 95 Radio. This is live at YouTube. Like and subscribe. Moein, we are under your service.
Definitely.
And we are so happy to see your talent. And Anna Schofield from England. I'm from Saudi Arabia.
This is how we wrote.
So let's try this. Yeah. I asked you to bring a dice with you. Yes, do you have a dice?
Yes, I have it.
So you have a dice. So a die, usually in the Arab world, we play Paula.
Paula.
Paula, we use a die with Paula.
Yeah.
Monopoly is
Monopoly.
You know, if you go to Las Vegas, of course, everywhere you have dice.
Everyone uses dice.
So what I would want you to do is that die that you have with you, I want you to try and change as many times as you want.
Okay.
And have a look at the number that's on the top.
Okay.
And don't show me and don't show Big Hass. And let me see if I could guess. What are you thinking of?
Okay.
Do you have a number?
I do.
Yes?
Oh, wow.
So have it like this. So that's the number, yes? So imagine that I have an X-ray eye. I could see through your hand and I could see the number on top. Is that possible?
I think so. Is it still on? Do you need me to make sure the number's still on the top of the die?
I mean, you can have a look if you want, yes.
No, but it's impossible for you to know the number.
I'm just saying. I mean, do you have a number, yes?
I have a number.
Okay. Do you want to change your mind or do you want to stick with the same number?
Change your mind, Anna. I'm telling you.
Okay, I'm going to change my mind.
Okay, change your mind.
You are a devil, Hass. Right, hang on, I'm looking.
Okay.
Okay, got it.
Okay.
Okay, a number that you picked.
I freaked out just looking at this, man.
Yeah, that's scary.
If you're watching
you picked a number. There is no way that I would know or anybody in the world would know that
I'm telling
number.
You.
I don't know why did you pick the number, but then maybe to confuse me, maybe there is something that you're thinking of. But is it number 5?
That's unbelievable.
No way. You're kidding.
That is unbelievable.
Anna, stop it.
Let's try this one more time. Oh. This time, show it to Big Hass so he is...
Let's get out of here, Megan.
He is an
unbelievable. I changed it at the last minute. It wasn't 5 before.
Anna, come on, let's do this.
All right. Right, I just want to make sure that the camera can see me.
So you want to not look, you want to show the camera, maybe I'm not going to look.
All right, I'm properly rolling it in my hand, and I'm just checking as well. There is numbers on all sides.
Can you show it to the camera, maybe? Show it to the camera.
Yeah, look, there's numbers.
Let's get the camera on it. Okay, 1 second. Camera, he's not looking. He's not looking.
Right.
Okay.
Okay, we're going to do it.
Okay.
Do you have a number? Did you
pick a number?
Did you pick a number? All right.
Which one? The one on top?
Yeah.
The one on top. There's no way he's knowing that, I'm telling you.
Okay.
Bro, if you know this one, I'm leaving the studio. Okay, let's see.
He has to concentrate.
Do you want to change your mind? Do you want to stick with
this? I'm going to stick with this time.
Number.
Yeah.
It's a challenge that he gave me, but I don't know if I'm going to be able to do it because I don't know if it's the heat of the magic or it's really hot.
It's really hot in here.
Is it number 1?
Yeah,
oh my
thank you very much.
God.
You know what? Let's try this.
Seriously,
can you show me your palm? Just show me your palm.
Oh, that's freaky. What's happening?
Okay, so
he's staring at my palm. I'm hoping he can see $20 million win.
Yeah, hopefully like that's gonna come to you one day. But then, if you look into her palm, you could see some. Just show it to Big Hass. Show it to Big Hass. You could see some letters there. Just focus.
Letter and a chef argam.
Argam is there, and if you just put something together, you will see. I see for some reason too. I see a heartbeat. Very, very strongly, I see an M, I see an A.
I see an M, I see an A.
An A and M. Some M and A. Is there anything that you could connect with M and A?
M and A.
Oh,
is a heart, strong heart, beat.
Strong heart. M and A.
M and A.
Are they different people? My son is called Albie.
Okay, and...
And the M...
What?
It would be the M.
Okay, so Albie, the heartbeat.
The heartbeat
and
is her son.
A on your hand. Okay.
Yeah.
So let's try this. Let's try something else.
Okay, amazing.
Let's try something
else. What goes on your mind? That's crazy, huh?
Let's try something else.
Don't even try me.
Let's go to Big House for a minute.
I don't want you to, but I'll allow it.
Big House, yeah. I would want you to go back in memory. I want you to go back in your life to your childhood. Now, I assume you have been a very naughty child.
Fact.
And I wanted to think of... I think of a friend of yours at that age.
Okay.
Yeah?
Okay.
And think of you guys doing something. Yes?
Okay.
Something. Yes? Mm. Now, so you are small. You are a kid.
Okay.
And there is somebody there.
Yeah.
I don't know why I'm getting this...
confusion.
Yeah, because
I'm confused.
A Capricorn, for some reason a Capricorn.
My friend is a Capricorn?
No, I'm just getting Capricorn.
Oh, a Capricorn.
Yes. And I feel a kid, but you know.
Yo, that's crazy.
Okay, so stop thinking of that. Stop thinking of that.
No, that's crazy. The Capricorn. Can I tell you what I was thinking about?
No, I think I am getting, I'm getting there. It's a kid.
Yeah.
Capricorn.
Yeah, there's Capricorn.
But not your friend. But there's something in your head. You're confusing me. This is the Capricorn is this emotion, strong emotion that you have toward this Capricorn kid, there is peace I could feel from inside you that you have toward the Capricorn. It's sort of a shadow. I could get a shadow.
Bro, if I tell you what I'm thinking about, you're going to go crazy.
I think you're thinking of your son, Ahmed, isn't it? But no, baby, maybe.
Wow.
Maybe. But your friend at that age that you were playing with.
Mm. How do you know I was playing with him?
Or maybe not.
He was, because he's blown away.
Or maybe. So the friend is Ghassan, if I'm not mistaken.
Is it? Oh, it must be.
What? How'd you know?
Wow. More. Do more. What else can you do?
And you,
bro, how?
You and him.
No, are, how? No, seriously, my heart is beating.
You and him are busy doing something. Busy doing something. I think sport, but you guys are watching NBA.
Yo, this guy is crazy. I'm going to tell you something right now that she doesn't know what you did to me before.
Okay. No, you can't tell her now. You can tell her later on. Just keep this. Just enjoy this moment. I am
enjoying this moment.
This is
crazy.
So you were playing?
Yeah. It's...
Okay.
Can I say? Like, what's going on here?
This is something that you have to embrace and enjoy.
Yo, man, this is crazy.
Wow.
I'm sure it's overwhelming, because when you were like, how? Like, what? How?
Yeah.
Wow. Wow, this is just... Yeah.
You see, that's not magic. That's more than magic, what you've just done with the dice and talking to us then. That's almost more than magic, because how could you possibly have known the things you've known?
How do you know, like, this guy's name?
I want you to think, now that we are still having this amazing moment, they say. I want you to, now we are in the pandemic, yes?
Yeah.
Some people are having difficulty traveling and going anywhere.
Yeah.
But I want you to imagine that pandemic is over.
Yeah.
And you've decided you're going to buy a ticket and travel.
I know where.
You do know. Mm. I just want to think of that.
Okay.
And think of where that is, and... I wanted
Man,
to
if you guess
imagine.
This one, I swear to God, what now?
I wanted to imagine that you are in a flight.
Yeah.
And you are flying to that destination.
Oh my God. Yeah.
I close your eyes for a minute.
Shall I imagine I'm there?
You know, imagine this whole journey you're going there, and imagine that you've landed there.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
And they are announcing the city that you've landed in, and they are saying welcome. To Tokyo,
Japan. Wow.
Oh my God.
Yeah, of course you love Japan.
What?
You love Japan.
He doesn't know that.
No. How do you know that? We haven't even said it on air.
No.
Have we said it on air?
How?
You thought Tokyo.
Yo, wow. Moein, man, I'm freaked out right now.
Wow.
Like, he knew exactly what I was thinking, playing with.
Yeah. Named him.
Mm. Figured out where I want to go in this, you know, obviously after this pandemic.
Mm.
Wow. What's going on here now? Like, what's that? Do you have a connection like this with everybody? Or, like, is it hard to have that connection like
that?
Well, we will just say abracadabra, I think, isn't it?
Huge.
And
it's amazing.
And try. The thing is, I think these moments are the moments that count, not the trick of bringing a deck of cards out and pick one and try and guess that. Yes.
Wow.
So I try and tend to do these kind of tricks more than other kind of tricks. So
can I ask you a question just before we go for a break? Because this was amazing. Does the tonality of your voice play a role? Because when I was closing my eyes, I was I tried, to be honest, really to immerse myself in the moment, thinking that will help you.
and
debating in myself, like, he's not gonna know it. There's no way he's not gonna know it. And then all of a sudden he's like, you go into talking. I'm like, what?
Also, when you looked at us and you were obviously searching for the answer, however you're doing that, which is super incredible.
He's really looking.
You look like you are looking right inside.
Thank you.
Goodness knows what else you're picking up while you're finding the number.
I want to know everything about her, but I'm just saying. But that's amazing, man. We're getting some questions from the audience, but we're going to take a short break. But that was just fantastic. That's trick number one. We're going to be back with you guys.
Can you stay till 8? Because it would be fun.
That would be funny.
Yeah.
You know, we definitely can maybe an extra 10 minutes here and there. But
Yalla Home
with Ella Scofield
and Big House.
And we're coming up for 10 to 6 on this Wednesday afternoon, sliding through till 8 p.m. tonight. If you're just joining us now, you've missed some amazing stuff from 5 o'clock. We have the most incredible magician, illusionist, I think it's important to say both, in the studio with us, Moein Al Bastaki.
Moein Al Bastaki,
Keeps correcting me. I'm going to have it by 8 o'clock.
You're saying it. You're saying it actually absolutely right. Okay. Try it again.
Oh, Moein Al Bastaki.
Moein.
Okay.
Moein.
Okay.
That's good enough. I'm okay with it. Yeah. Anyway,
and he said, you were such a gentleman because you turned around and went, it's okay, call me Mo.
Oh, good. For
which,
sure.
Which I love. Off air is as fun with you as on air, because I want everyone to know that there is no pretending in here. So if Mo had actually said the wrong number when I was doing everything you asked me to do with the dice, if you'd got it wrong, we would have said no.
Definitely.
You know, and in terms of things you guessed, and the things you guessed about Hass knew about Hass were remarkable.
And thank you for that, man, really. We have a question here from Suad. Shout out to you, Suad. Thank you for always tuning in. She's like, magic and illusion, what's the difference?
Well, magic gives you the full umbrella of what goes as part of what magic is. Illusion is definitely doing something, giving the impression to people that you're doing something, but you're doing something else.
Mm-hmm. Right.
But then that's only one branch of what magic is, because we have different branches of magic.
Yeah.
You have got the stage shows, tricks are different than the close-up magic, that are different than the birthday tricks, kids tricks, mentalism, psychic reading. All these goes under the umbrella of magic.
Mm.
So illusion is one part of it, and illusion is what you might see either on stage or sometimes on TV.
Yeah.
But then what we are doing in the studio is very real.
Very real.
Another question we have from Abdullah. He's like, have you ever seen the movie Illusionist?
I did.
And what do you
I'm do like,
think? That's a very typical question
definitely
to ask.
Definitely. Every magician would have seen it.
Yeah, what do you think of
it? No, loved it. I mean, the thing is, whatever movie comes out that is talking about magic is promoting our art. So we magicians love that.
Right.
So the Illusionist, the Prestige was there.
Oh, the Prestige. Yeah.
So, what was that? The Do you know what? That was like the four magicians, a lady and three magicians. Yeah. I'm not recalling the name.
Yeah.
So lots of movies out there on magic. The Mentalist, the series. If you guys have seen that.
Have you seen that?
Oh, yeah, definitely. That's that's usually what I try and tend into. So we try some more stuff here.
Yes.
Here we
yes.
go. Let's go.
So so Big Cass, I asked you to bring with you a Tinderum bell.
Bell, I have it here.
Yes.
Right here.
So I want you to not open it yet.
Okay, don't open
so
it.
So you have your bell.
Scramble.
Have I ever touched or seen that bell?
No.
I've never.
To be honest.
Is actually not. Is it not? Is it your bell or somebody else's?
It's actually not mine. I went to Afternoon Karak's Mikey.
Okay.
Shout out to Mikey. And I didn't have a 10 dirham bill, okay, and so, I borrowed it from him.
So what I would want you to do, I don't know if this is going to work or not. Yep. I wanted to open the bell, but then hide it so I don't and Anna don't see the bell. Yes.
Under the
just
table.
Under the table.
Under the table.
I open it down, or I open it here.
Yeah, but then for us not to see. Whatever makes so you comfortable. Whatever makes you comfortable. Yes.
Great.
So. Have that bell opened, and every bell has got a serial number.
Come on, bro.
You're so, not gonna do that. Wow.
So, and of course, the central banks do not print a bell with the same number.
No.
It is all different,
okay.
Yes? So this is not my bell. This is Hass's bell, who's taken the bell from Mikey. Yes?
Shout out Mikey, So he's looking right here.
So he's Mikey's around.
There's a crowd gathering in studio too.
So here we go. So open the bell and find the serial number. I don't know if I would be able to guess it. It's going to be impossible, but I'm going to try.
Come on, Hass. Open it
Do you have the bell open? Just make sure that nobody's seeing. So you have a serial number, don't you?
We do.
Yeah, you do. Okay,
I mean,
you can see.
There is a numbers,
There is numbers, yes?
Yeah.
So I wanted to look at the first number, yes?
Yeah.
I wanted to think of the number. I see emptiness. I don't see an actual number. I see some empty space. I don't know why.
You're freaking me out right now. I'm
serious. Is it zero? Okay, so the first number is zero. Let's go for this.
Zero. Amazing.
Let's go to the second number. Think of a second number.
Yo, guys, ladies and gentlemen, please watch on YouTube because this is crazy. Okay.
Think of the second number. The second number, I want you to think of it in a different language if you know. So if you're thinking in Arabic, think in English, any other language, you know, think of that so you can confuse me a bit.
Oh.
So we had zero, we have...
There's no way you're going to guess that.
So this number could be read as two numbers if looked at from different angle.
Good God.
So this is...
It's crazy, man. What is the number?
Six.
Wow! Yeah.
Okay, I feel some... I feel some repetition for some reason. Are you thinking of moving your house for some reason?
Are you thinking of moving house?
No, not really. But I mean, we just moved house.
You just moved house. So that was what I get.
So
06. That's the reason I got this repetition. This was like a house moving. It's 1-1.
Wow! What? Yo, this is crazy.
06-11. I'm writing this down.
Again, a repetitive number. I think a zero again.
Yo, you guys, I'm not kidding. It is the numbers. You're saying it. He's never seen the bill that I have.
I feel one again.
I'm out of this world right now.
270. 270, yes?
Two?
270. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Wow, that's incredible.
Guys, the number is, tell me the number, Anna.
06-11-01-270.
06-11-01-270. That's the serial number of a 10. They're clapping
they're
in the
clapping
studio over
studio
here.
Studio too. Amazing.
This is a bill that I got from Mikey. It's not even mine.
And you screwed it up.
And what I did was like I scrambled it.
Yeah.
Supposedly gave it to you, but then we gave it back to me. He never seen it. He's never seen it, actually, to be honest. He's never even touched it. The only thing he's done, and there's no way, look, I'm going to show you. There's no way you're going to get the number like that. There's no way.
The numbers are tiny. That's amazing.
And I just put it in an envelope, and now we opened it, and now this incredible guy right here figured it out.
You have to give it back to Mikey, or that's yours now?
Bro, I'm going to sell this.
eBay, isn't it?
Selling the note.
Sign it. Yeah, he's asking for you to sign it.
Oh, definitely.
Yeah, that's a great thing.
For sure.
Oh, man. And we'll give it to Mikey, of course. But
can I ask, do you like it? Do you like doing this?
You know what?
Do you love it?
I love you guys reacting so kindly to it. That, to me, That means the world.
I gotta ask you, you gotta stay 10 more minutes because I know we have until 6, but you gotta stay like until like 6:10 or something
because
like that.
Because we have your grandfather's watch. You know?
Sure, definitely. Yeah.
How long did this trick take? You know, just because I don't want to interrupt you with the news.
So so how many minutes we have here? We've got like 4 minutes.
We
could... Okay, let's do this trick. Yes?
Let's do it.
I don't know, again, if this is going to work. I mean, I try my best, but then this whole connectivity, it sometimes does, it sometimes does not.
Okay.
So my grandfather, when I was a small kid, had this box.
Okay.
Yeah? And he always had told me not to open the box.
Okay.
And I was always keen to go and open this box that my grandfather had in house.
Okay. Yeah, of course.
I wanted to go and he used to sneak see me that I'm going for the box. And he was like, I told you not to open the box. So I said, okay, I'm sorry. So until he passed away, yeah?
God rest
and
his soul in peace.
He actually gave me what was inside the box, which was this... pocket watch.
Okay. Mm.
What I would want you to do, I want you to have it on your palm. Yes?
Okay.
Have this on your palm. I'm going to have a pad. Sorry, my voice maybe went. I have a pad.
Okay.
I want you to think of a time. Yeah? I want you to think of the hours.
Oh, okay. All right.
And think of an hour. Any hour you want.
Like 5, 6 p.m., 2 p.m., 3 p.m.
Whatever she wants.
Okay. Got it.
Just tell me one. Tell me what the hour is. You can tell me.
I can say 11 p.m.
11. Okay. 11 p.m.
Specific.
And now I want you to think of the minutes.
Yes.
Okay.
Tell me.
Two.
11 or 2. Yes?
Yeah.
So you had... a time that you've decided on, yes? There is no way anybody...
No, you are not going to open this.
...would know...
No way.
...the time. Is it possible?
No.
From billions of options of time for us to have 11:02. I want you to click... The top, or no, just click the top. No, yeah? No, no,
down.
Yes.
And we'll
it's going to open. Just look
at
the
time. Oh, my goodness, it's 11:02.
Oh.
Look. Where's our camera? There, they can see it. 11:02.
Oh.
That's unbelievable.
Insane.
It's unbelievable.
Okay, wait.
Because I haven't seen that.
Can we talk about what just happened a little bit?
Go.
Is it possible?
Yeah, of course.
Because, so you hear, wow. So is it an illusion or a magic or a combination of both?
Or is it you tuning in to...
Because this is incredible because obviously, wow. You've never met Anna.
No,
okay?
No,
that's the first time you meet.
Yeah.
There's no way you would know even if like... Because she doesn't, you know, like... I don't. Even her Instagram, which is like, you know, seriously, she needs a lot.
I'm rubbish.
We need like, she doesn't even put out information. She's the voice of Emirates Airlines. When you call Emirates Airlines, she's actually the voice.
Wow, okay.
Yeah. Big deal right here.
Amazing.
And then like now, she chose 11 and then 2. Very specific.
It's very specific.
Wow.
And it's there.
How did you do that?
On the watch. It's a beautiful watch, by the way.
Thank you.
Yeah. I'm very special to you.
I am super, super, we're super honored, really. This is incredible.
Yeah.
But we want to ask you to stay like 7 more minutes, if possible. Shout out to my sisters out there, of course, the sisters
filming
as well.
Everything.
Mahal
Thank
to Philippines.
So
Moein Al Bastaki, you are incredible in everything that you do, my man. We're going to be right back with him. It's not over yet. Pulse 95 Radio.
It's Yalla Home.
Yalla Home.
With Anna Schofield.
And Big Cass.
Live here at Yalla Home right through till 8 o'clock. Normally at this time of the day, we'd be going and coming up in the hour, but there is absolutely no need because we are literally hanging on to our guest by his ankles and not letting him leave.
We're not letting him leave.
He's such fun. He's wonderful. We've got an illusionist, an incredible magician with us in the studio, Moein Al Bastaki. Trying here.
No, you're doing great, I think.
And Mo has just blown us away several times. Thing is, every time we come off air, Hass is like, how do you do that? Tell me what you're doing. How are you thinking? Like, and completely throwing like, questions at him. Yeah. Give me the answer.
Best of key right here
but
from
it is
the UAE
really
to the world. Amazing. Just
to the
incredible.
World.
And like we say, and God bless you. Before we kind of see that last trick, I just want to say, seriously, you go on many stages, you know, before the pandemic, and you represent not only the UAE, you represent, you know, the Arab region, you represent Islam, and you go through, and this is just fantastic for people to
Thank
see.
You.
quick question. Do you always perform with the kandura now?
Yes, it depends on the occasion.
Yeah. Right.
If I'm doing anything media-wise, yeah. I'm showing off my identity.
Okay. Yeah.
I'm from the
Gulf country. You're into the Emirati.
Yes. Yeah. So that's what I do. But then if sometimes I'm booked for, let's say, a corporate gig yeah. and there's yeah. not much of many of Arabs there, yeah. I don't go. I go with a casual dress.
Okay. Okay.
But usually you would see lots of Arabs, especially in UAE or in the Gulf yeah. countries when I'm booked.
How does the family feel about what you're doing now?
Now they're loving it. I mean, they used to not, but then now...
are they your biggest
every
fan?
Time, I mean, my mother's like, okay, you know what? Are you dressed this way? Are you whatever? Have you taken care of yourself before you go? So she's like very keen for me to present myself to people like very in the best way possible.
Wow. And what about your wife? Because I honestly, if I was your wife, I'd be saying all the time, can you do another trick, darling? I'd be all the... Is she asking you to do tricks all the time just because it's fun?
You know, I think you're not a celebrity in your home somehow. You know, it's like you are unique outside, yeah, but when you're back at that at your place...
You're just dad, you know?
She likes what I do, yeah. but then until the time it brings some money in, then yes, I think, but then otherwise... Otherwise, if God it's not, then why you're wasting your time?
Yeah.
But no, she's keen on things that I do, but then she doesn't know how it's done. So
wow.
yeah,
she always tries, like, you know, pushing me to tell her the secrets, but I try.
And is it true real magicians don't say the secret?
You
is
know
that
what?
The concept?
No, it depends on... yeah, I mean, what I've done today, these are my secret, yes?
Yeah.
But I've taught lots of magic in my products... for people to go and learn and perform and entertain the people, their family or friends, yes? So I don't keep all the secrets. I give out secrets. I give sessions.
Mm.
I give workshops. And I teach people lots of these deep secrets of magic.
And you can definitely go buy the products. They're really very, very affordable, in my opinion. Just, you know, search Moein Al Bastaki on any kind of platform. You'll be able to also get that, which is big up to you. Okay, what do we have right here?
Yeah,
so let's end it with a big bomb, isn't it? Yes?
Yeah.
So... what we have here, I would want you to, Anna, to check this bulb. Is it a real bulb? Is it made of chocolates?
Is it made of chocolate?
Yeah, it's
not made of chocolate.
Some people might suspect that this might be like, you know, a gimmicky kind of bulb.
It's a real bulb.
Yeah,
it looks like
a real
bulb.
Yeah. So
what I would want you to do,
normal clear.
Big hats, I want you to wrap the bulb in the bandana and I want you to smash it into pieces.
Nah.
Oh, you've given him the best bit.
Smash what into pieces?
The bulb.
So put the bulb in the bandana.
Be careful, because that will splinter into lots of little bits.
Yeah, just cover the whole bulb with the bandana.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Grab the bandana from the side, let's say like that, so you could then smash it to the ground and into pieces.
Come on, take out your anger. Go on.
Yes.
Legit?
Yeah, you.
Seriously?
Yes.
Come on.
On the table? Yeah.
On the ground, everywhere. Anywhere. That just break the bulb. That's not a really impossible task, isn't it?
Come on. I'm going to do it for him if he doesn't do it.
Just
come on. Break the glass. Break it.
Ew, excellent.
He's so funny. Look. Oh,
okay,
go.
good. Okay, that's broken, isn't it? Yes. You can bring the bandana.
I would say it's broken. It's destroyed, bro.
It's all right. Just bring the bandana forward.
Yeah.
Open it, and I want Anna to go and pick a piece from the glass.
Amazing. Right, I'm going over.
Okay, one second. I'm going to bring it right here, and I just hope we're able to catch this somehow. I'm
just
opening.
Just be very careful, please. Yeah. It's real glass, as you could see.
Yeah.
Just take my mic with me.
Okay.
Any piece?
I mean, whatever makes you happy.
Oh, ow. No kidding.
Yeah. You want to go with bigger one? You want to go with that one? It's all your pick, your choice.
Yeah, I'll go for a bigger one. Hold on.
So now let me paint you a picture, you guys. I just broke a bulb. I think that's the first bulb I've ever broken in my life.
Right?
And now it's inside the bandana. And of course, there's glass all
Millions
over. And Anna has picked up one piece of glass.
Yeah.
So Anna, this is a real glass. We are not playing around here. This is real stuff, yes?
Yeah.
What I want you to do, I'm not going to touch the glass in no way. I want you to put the piece of that glass piece on my tongue.
On your tongue?
Just put it on my tongue.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, this is happening live, ladies and gentlemen.
So for the people listening to us while driving, you will enjoy this.
Don't try this at home, for sure.
Yeah.
Second of all, that's happening right here, ladies and gentlemen. She's putting it. There's a glass right now. You can watch it.
I feel so bad putting glass on my
tongue. There's a glass on Moein Al Bastaki's tongue right now. Obviously, this is a glass from the broken bulb. It's there.
And it's a big bit, okay?
And now Moein... La.
Kids do not do this ever. He's crunching it.
Yo, this is crazy.
No.
Oh my God, my heart beats. We're impressed, we're impressed. Wallahi, we love you, like, bro.
Oh, yeah. Can't believe what is going on.
Yeah, that's why he was telling you the big one. Yeah.
He's now unscrewing water.
Oh, wow. Guys, this is just... We're going to put this, the whole video, tomorrow.
Yeah.
This is happening.
Okay. Almost like he's taking a pill.
Oh my God, he just...
Yeah. Are you swallowing?
No way. Oh my God. Wow.
It's hard on radio because I don't want to speak while you're doing this.
This
but
is...
But people are listening.
Well, first
so...
of all, how are you? Like, wow, look, he's a bit...
He's
also, there's a bit tears, but you swallowed the whole... Wow. This is just... I don't know what to say, man. I'm We,
oh, he has swallowed it.
The whole thing is
he
gone.
He crunched it and swallowed it.
911, please.
Yeah. We've got a gentleman here who is eating glass. If you could remove him.
Please don't try this at home.
Yeah.
Whoever is watching or listening to us, this is done by professional
magicians. And you
asked
me to get you a bigger bit. You said... Do you want to choose a bigger bit of glass?
I knew Anna will tend to want to harm me.
We didn't even know what you want to do with it. But man, subhanAllah. Yani, yatik alf afya. God bless. Moein Al Bastaki. Go follow him right now. Just fantastic. I loved every single. And, wow. And this is like you've done, what, 3 or 4 really tricks in a radio atmosphere.
Close. Really close. So we've seen everything.
Yeah. If you don't mind, I'm going to tell you right now, like, we want to really have the pleasure of getting you again.
Definitely.
Soon, inshallah. I hope you had fun. Any last words you'd like to say?
I mean, thank you
very
much.
I don't know if you can talk right now, but, you know,
no, I can definitely talk. Thank you very much for inviting me over. It's been an honor to be with you guys.
Oh, wow. It's
and I hope that your audiences have just enjoyed what we've done here. And I'm sure next time we're going to bring better, bigger, more amazing tricks.
What can we expect in the next few months from Moein Al Bastaki?
Well, you know, coming back to the show here, I'm going to read the audience's mind. So that's what you guys are going to get from me.
Oh, read the audience's mind.
We'll get people to call in and he's going to, he's going to read their minds.
Well, someone will call in and you'd figure out what they think.
We will try that live on air with you guys.
Yeah.
I've got lots of bookings happening, I think, with the vaccine hopefully coming in.
Yeah.
People have started booking me for lots of shows.
Amazing.
So that's happening. So
people can follow you on Instagram to find out where you're performing.
For sure,
Moein Al Bastaki, which is you know, the account is available on Pulse 95. Please go also follow him. I don't know what to say.
No, it's amazing.
It feels like I don't want to let him go.
I don't want him to go.
Like, we already had 12 more minutes, but
thank you so much.
Thank
remarkable.
You,
what an incredible career. I always think that, you know, we're quite lucky because we have super fun jobs tonight, as an example. But I think you top that.
I think
your job is crazier and better and most incredible thing ever.
Thank you so much for blessing us with your time.
If you liked this episode of Yalla Home, drop a like and subscribe.
95.
Be sure to follow us on Instagram for all our daily updates and top stories.